So in the last class, we have seen equation of continuity. So here it is. That is A1 V1 is equal to A2 V2. And that implies AV is always equal to constant. Okay. Yes, up to this we have finished. Yes, no? Now, note point. Suppose we have like this pipe. Suppose now like this pipe is there and liquid is flowing through this end, means in this direction, okay? So it will come out here also, through this also, and through this also. So let us assume that the area of cross-section of this end is A, and velocity of fluid is P. Whereas from this, you have A1, P1, and this side A2 and P2. Here it is, let us suppose A3 and P3. This A is area of cross section, P is velocity of fluid entering the pipe. From this end, or for this pipe, A1 is area of cross section and V1 is the velocity which is coming out. That is for fluid only. This side area is A2, velocity is V2. Similarly here, area is A3 and velocity is V3. Now, from equation of continuity, if such thing or like this case you are getting, then what we will do? Whatever the fluid is entering, yes, no. So, what we will get? A into V is equal to A1 V1 plus A2 V2 plus A3 V3. So, it is same like entering is equal to sum of leaving. Yes, no? So this is entering and you can say area into velocity is equal to this A1 V1 plus A2 V2 plus A3 V3. If you have two pipes joined or three or more, whatever it is, you just see entering end and leaving end. Like that you can do it. Okay? Understood? Clear?
Yes, sir.
Note down this.
Yes, sir.
So see the next topic, that is pressure energy. And for that, we are taking one container. Okay. Like this. And now we will keep one piston here. And this piston, we are moving inside with the displacement X. Okay. And this is the liquid inside this. On its height, pH. Okay. Now, first of all, what is mean by pressure energy? What is mean by pressure energy? So it is very simple. The energy possessed. The energy possessed by virtue of its pressure is called pressure energy. Yes, no? The energy possessed by virtue of its pressure is called pressure energy. Now, see here, we have a formula that is work is equal to force into displacement. Yes, no? What is the formula?
Right.
Work is equal to force into displacement, and this work done is nothing but pressure energy. And therefore, W is equal to F into displacement here is X. Whatever force you are applying, yes, this force into the displacement is equal to your work done. And now this F I am replacing, as if suppose we have area of cross section is small a, area of cross section of this is small a, then we know formula. P is equal to F by A. That implies F is equal to P into A. And therefore, P into A into X. This is what? Work done. And now this W is equal to, can I write as a P into V? Yes, no? W is equal to P A X, which is equal to P V. And this is nothing but what? Pressure energy. This formula is for pressure energy. Okay, got it. Now some note points you see here. Note point number one. Pressure energy per unit volume is equal to W by V, series volume, which is equal to P phi divided by phi. This V and this V will get cancelled. This is equal to P. Number two note point, pressure energy per unit mass that is equal to PV by M, which is equal to P by rho. Why? Because as you know, rho is equal to M by V. So P by M is equal to 1 by rho. Yes, no. So here V by M is there. That's why which I have replaced with 1 by rho. Understood? Next one. Pressure energy per unit weight. Pressure energy per unit weight. That is equal to PV by MG, and that is equal to P by rho G, and this is called pressure head. What we are calling it as a pressure head means pressure energy per unit weight is also called as pressure head. So these are the three note points. So note down now. This is water only. We are just pushing it inside, okay? Against the pressure, we are doing some work, okay? That is what this pressure energy is. We are pushing, no, this side.
Yes, sir.
We are applying force here. So here also liquid only, okay? Water only.
Okay, sir.
Now let's move ahead to the next concept, that is Bernoulli's theorem. So first of all, what is the statement? So before going forward, let me tell you some things which is basic, which is necessary to understand this Bernoulli's theorem. We know kinetic energy formula, that is what, half m v square. Also we know pressure energy formula.
W is equal to PV.
That is PV. And we know potential energy formula also. What is potential energy formula? MGH.
H.
Now, kinetic energy per unit volume is equal to half M V square divided by capital V. So can I write like this, half into rho into V square? Because this M by V is nothing but what? Rho. Yes, no? Next, similarly, this pressure energy per unit volume is equal to what? P and potential energy per unit volume is equal to what? MGH by V, which is equal to rho GH. Understand? Is that clear?
Yes, sir.
So kinetic energy per unit volume is nothing but half rho V square. Pressure energy per unit volume is nothing but P. And potential energy per unit volume is nothing but rho GH. This you understand? Yes, no? Yes, clear?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
So what is the statement of this Bernoulli's theorem now? Just see. This you understand now? Okay. So see here, I am writing the statement now on the basis of this only. See here. When a non-viscous means which should flow freely, you know? So non-viscous, incompressible means which should not compress, incompressible fluid flows steadily, means laminar, hai na? Laminar flow, steadily flow means laminar, hai na? The sum of the pressure energy, the sum of pressure energy comma kinetic energy and potential energy per unit volume is or volume of the fluid remains constant at all points in the path of flow. Means what? In simple language, P plus half rho V square plus rho GH, which is equal to constant. Is that clear? So pressure energy per unit volume, kinetic energy per unit volume, and potential energy per unit volume, its sum is always going to be constant. Or we can say like this also, the sum of pressure energy, kinetic energy, potential energy per unit volume is always constant at all points in the path of flow. Okay. This is what your Bernoulli's theorem statement or statement of Bernoulli's theorem. Understood this?
Yes, sir.
Clear?
Yes, sir.
Note down this fast. So this derivation is a little bit lengthy. So we will continue tomorrow, otherwise it will be in between only, okay? Shall we stop here?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Bye, sir. Aapne paper dekhe, sir.
Thank you.
Answer papers dekhe, sir, hamare?
Nahin.